disconnect the battery, you need to flip the unit over and take out all of the bottom cover screws. And then you can flip the unit over and open it up. Now you can use your spudger to take the palm rest off. Now you can grab the battery cable and disconnect it from the motherboard. We disconnect the battery to prevent any shortages to the motherboard or the LCD. Now you can disconnect the touchpad ribbon and the keyboard ribbon. And remove the palm rest. Now we can do the motherboard replacement. It is important to remember to be grounded when handling a motherboard to prevent any static electricity damage to the board. So now you can remove all of the motherboard screws, including the Wi-Fi screw. Now that all the screws are out, you can start disconnecting everything from the motherboard. You can disconnect the LCD cable. And you can disconnect the speakers. And the two USB ribbons. And the Wi-Fi bracket. Once you remove the Wi-Fi bracket, you can take the Wi-Fi card screw out. And then remove the Wi-Fi card. And the camera cable. Once everything is disconnected, you can carefully remove the motherboard. Now you can grab your new motherboard and carefully put it back into place. Make sure no cables or wires are underneath of the board. And then you can reconnect everything except for the battery. So you can reconnect the camera cable. And the Wi-Fi card. And once the Wi-Fi card is reconnected, you can put that screw back in. Then you can reconnect the two USB ribbons. And the speakers. And the LCD cable. Now that everything's reconnected, you can put all of the motherboard screws back in, and you can also put the Wi-Fi card bracket back on and put that screw back in. Now you want to grab your palm rest and reconnect the touchpad ribbon and the keyboard ribbon. Once those are reconnected, now you can reconnect the battery. And then put the palm rest back on. And then close the unit and put the bottom cover screws back in. To verify that the repair was successful, you can grab your AC adapter and plug the unit in. And then open the unit up. And if the unit turns on, that means the replacement was successful. And if you would like to check to see if the battery is working properly, you can just unplug the unit. And if it stays on while it is no longer plugged in, then that means the battery is working. So now you can shut the unit down.